Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.2.3. This is available to all iOS 13 and iPadOS supported devices, and this one came in at 101.3 megabytes on my iPhone 8 Plus. Now, it may vary depending on your device. I actually saw it smaller and a little bit larger depending on the device, but let's go ahead and take a look at the build number. The build number is 17B111, and this particular build does not really show any new features, but is all about additional bug fixes. And we've seen a lot of this from Apple lately with 13.1, 13.2, 13.2.1, and on and on and on. So 13.2.2 was only about a week or so ago, and now we've got 13.2.3. And this one addresses four specific bugs that seem like they're underlying frameworks that are fixed in all of these devices. So that's the good news. So let's talk about the actual fixes, then we'll talk about battery, then we'll talk about speed and performance, and then we'll run some benchmarks using Geekbench. So the first one fixes an issue where system search and system within mail, files, and notes might not work. So if you're having problems searching any of those, mail, I've heard of a lot of issues with mail recently. I've had a few people message me where not only will search when you're looking for something specific not work, but it wasn't working in other ways, and this addresses those as well. Now, the next thing they've fixed has to do with photos, links, and other attachments not showing properly in your messages details. So what that means is if you go into messages or iMessage, and then you tap on the name at the top here, you've got details, hit the I, and then under this, you can share your own location, but photos and links and things like that may not have been showing properly before. So they're now showing up properly under the messages details. Now the next fix has to do with one that could prevent apps from downloading content in the background. So maybe you were downloading a file in Safari or another app, and then you exited it out to go into music or something like that. It now will continue to download in the background, of course, unless you close the app out itself. So it fixes those issues where it would just close everything out. Now, the final thing they fixed has to do with mail. Now, prior to this, you may have an issue where mail was not grabbing or fetching your mail properly. That should now work. It also may have failed to include and quote original messages if you were using Exchange within the mail app, and that is now fixed. So hopefully mail is going to work properly and fast now, where it was a little bit slow before. It should be resolved. And that's it as far as the notes are concerned from Apple. In fact, there's nothing else when it comes to any of the older iPhones or even the iPad. iPadOS gets the same exact bug fixes that iOS does, but there's nothing new in it. So don't expect any new features or changes, or at least any that they've mentioned anyway. And then also, there's no security fixes that they've mentioned. So expect that to be the same as well. So that's really it for this. And now I do have my iPhone 8 Plus here, and speed and performance over the past hour or so that it's been out, not even an hour, seem to be okay. It's about the same as it was before. I had no issues whatsoever. And this phone is actually a mirror of my normal daily 11 Pro Max. So it's kind of an older backup phone. And if we take a look at some of the storage, I know a lot of people are always concerned about the system storage. This is a 64 gigabyte phone. And we'll wait for it to load here, and we'll see how much of the system it's using. So if we scroll down to the bottom, it's using only 5.63 gigabytes of system and 12.54 gigabytes of other. So that's a good sign. It's down from what I had on my 11 Pro Max. So hopefully storage is less used for you as well. Although that can change and vary depending on time. Now, other than that, battery life has been okay for most people, at least on my iPad Pro here. I can show you that because I use this all the time. Now, battery life on the previous build of iOS 13.2.2 or iPadOS 13.2.2 was okay. It was not phenomenal, but it was okay. And you'll see some of my usage here. A lot of it was screen off time if I go to certain ones, but it was using a lot of the battery. Hopefully this resolves any issues with battery, but I haven't really seen anything as far as that goes. And it will take a few days to know as far as battery life. You really can't measure it from 100% rolling back down. That's not, you really need to give it a day or two to see what battery life is like in general. Now, I did run a Geekbench on all of these devices. On the iPhone 11, 11 Pro, I would expect great scores. And you'll see on the iPhone 11, I scored 1333, which seems to be pretty consistent for some reason, always around that number. And then 3403 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history, you'll see that we're getting about the same as we did before, very close to those same numbers. Now let me lay out all of these different devices so you can get an idea what yours should be as well. On the left, we have the iPad Pro. Then next we have the iPhone 8 Plus, then we have the iPhone 11, and then we have the iPhone 11 Pro. So hopefully this gives you an idea of what yours should be near. They're being pretty consistent with recent updates, so I wouldn't expect this to change too much. Now, if you're concerned about performance and things like that on older devices, such as the iPhone SE or 6S or 6S Plus, I really wouldn't be too concerned about any of those. In general, it's going to be the exact same as iOS 13.2.2, but just with the updated fixes that they've implemented with this current version of iOS 13.2.3. So all of these numbers are getting a little bit confusing, and all of these updates, I'm surprised they're pushing them out this fast, but really this is getting us to the point of where iOS 13 is stable and is what it should have been with its initial release. So hopefully things are much better for you this week, and be sure to follow back for a follow-up that I'll do. Normally at the end of the week, I'll do a poll on the YouTube community tab, and then we'll do a video usually in the weekend, Saturday or Sunday. So be sure to check back for that, where I include things like battery life and different bugs and things you might experience. Now, as far as iOS 13.3 is concerned, I would expect it to come out maybe with a beta this week and next, and maybe we'll see the final release in the first week of December. It's hard to say exactly when they're going to release it, but that's kind of what I'm expecting at this point. That's it for iOS 13.2.3. Let me know if you've found anything else significant in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.